The history of the bow and arrow has been developed along with the history of humanity for a long time. In the past, it was used as a stunning battle tool. Along with the era, it is being used for hunting needs or as a weapon in sacred rituals. It was developed from old road to the present. The true purpose is training the mind and body through the bow. To Japan, where bows made in Kyoto are known as Kyoyumi, 250 years ago, there were around 50 bow makers working in the Gokomachi area of Kyoto City, producing bows for samurai and the nobility. There is now only one such household in Kyoto and it belongs to Shibata Kanjuro. Shibata's son, Ryunhiro, has worked with his father for as long as he can remember. Ryunhiro, the eldest son of the Shibata Kanjuro Yumi shop, who inherits the process of Kyoyumi from generation to generation for about half a century. The origin of the Kyoyumi dates back to the Warring States period, and the beginning was made by Shibata Kanjuro, the first archer who served in the Shimazu clan in 1534. It is also said that in the Honnoji incident, there is a legend that the bow drawn by Oda Nobunaga toward the army of Akechi Mitsuhide was Shibata's bow. The tradition of the Shibata family has a history of about 500 years. Now there is only one such household in Kyoto. He grew up watching his father's work from an early age and was conscious of becoming a bow craftsman in the future. When he was about 23 years old, he became a disciple of his father. When his father retires, Ryunhiro will inherit his name and become the 22nd Kanjuro to head the household. There is a long tradition, and even in modern times, the Japanese bow used in Kyudo and Kyujutsu is also more than 2 meters in length, the largest size in the world. Kyoyumi are famous for their strength, resilience and elegance, is said to have a strong attractive while being supple and a sharp sharpness. The area's high humidity and extremes in temperature produce a variety of bamboo that is small in circumference but has a highly dense fiber. This makes for an extremely difficult material to work with. This hard, resilient bamboo is ideally suited to be part of the mechanism of a bow. So at first glance, Kyoto bows have a slender, feminine quality. But if you actually hold one and bend the bowstring, you realize how formidable and strong Kyoto bows are. Kyoyumi differ from other forms of bows made in Japan in shape, and especially in the material they are made of.
Thank you.